teaching critical and creative thinking skills. Critical thinking in the language classroom. Let's try to define what critical thinking is and why it is so important to teach this skill in the language classroom. What is critical thinking? Critical thinking is one of the essential skills to master at school. It is one of the core skills often referred to as 21st century skills, which are of critical importance when it comes to functioning effectively in today's world. How do we define critical thinking? What does it entail? To put it simply, critical thinking can be described as thinking about thinking. Critical thinking is about analyzing, evaluating an issue or problem, and assessing it from multiple perspectives. Critical thinking encompasses problem solving by questioning all the arguments and conclusions and making sure that all the necessary information is available. Critical thinking is making well-informed decisions based on evidence and facts. So, critical thinkers have the ability to analyze and criticize, are able to review the source of information and what biases the source may have, listen to the message, analyze the presented information, seek out hidden messages, and make decisions about the information using all of these resources. So the next question is, what are critical thinking strategies that can be utilized in the classroom? Here are some simple ways to help students start thinking critically in the language classroom. Categorizing material. Organizing things into groups for or with students can help them better analyze the topic. Brainstorming. Discussing and creating a list of things related to the topic can help students generate ideas. Comparing and contrasting. Relating a new topic to something the students already know is a great way to get critical thinking started. Asking questions. More questions will always get students to think more. If the students are capable enough, follow a what question with a how do you know will get more responses. This can also be used in a discussion to learn more about the topic. Some examples of what questions are, what is the situation? What is the problem I must solve? What are my intuitions, assumptions about the situation or problem? What information do I have, need, and could reasonably find? What are some different possibilities, options, or alternatives? What's important or what counts? What are reasonable criteria? What possibility best fits my idea of what counts? Develop critical thinking by using why and how. Pose questions that require students to dig deeper. This is the simplest and easiest strategy that you might want to utilize in your classroom right away. Take on the role of a facilitator rather than that of a teacher and encourage discussions, guiding your students in exploring the topic by posing open-ended questions. When reading, ask students to think critically about what they have read. Ask students to make predictions during reading and listening activities. This way, learners are encouraged to assess the various components of the presented information while also making reasonable judgments about possible outcomes and developments. Use project-based learning when teaching English. PBL lets you synthesize language learning objectives with critical thinking skills. Project-based learning tasks and activities combine language and action so that learners learn by doing. Learners need to understand, explore, analyze, assess, and create while using English to complete a task or activity. This results in enhanced language skills while also having a positive effect on and further honing the critical thinking skills of your students. To help our students develop critical thinking skills, we might also want to make more rigorous use of graphic organizers, templates, and designs. Graphic organizers are instrumental when teaching students to organize and simplify more complex information. Graphic organizers let students visualize and explore relationships between concepts and better analyze the issue at hand. For example, a spider diagram can be excellent for teaching students how to validate information, assess the credibility of a source, distinguish between relevant and irrelevant info, and tell facts from opinions. A Venn diagram is another graphic organizer that can come in handy when teaching critical thinking to your students. It can be useful when they need to compare and contrast, and also to categorize similar and dissimilar attributes of objects and sort out their individual parts.